Welcome to ABC Interactive English. I'm Matt.
And I'm Nina.
Today we're taking a look at part two of A Magical Time at Tokyo DisneySea Fantasy Springs. So, Nina, last time we were talking about our Disney experiences and you mentioned that you've actually been to Tokyo DisneySea.
Yes, I went last year and it was the first Disney I had ever been to. Okay. So needless to say, it was really exciting for me. And it was actually so good because Tokyo actually has Disneyland and DisneySea next to each other. But before I went, I did some research and people said that DisneySea is definitely the place to spend more time.
Okay.
So we spent 2 days there and it wasn't even enough. It was so much fun. And I kept on going on some really exciting rides and got to experience so many different themes. It was really a great time.
So what do you think was the best ride at Tokyo DisneySea?
I forgot the name, but it was a roller coaster. I think it went through some mountains and it was like dark and it was really fast.
Wow, okay. That sounds like an exciting ride.
And it was.
Yeah, so I think they have these different areas at these Disney parks, and today we're going to be talking about this new one, Fantasy Springs, and we'll get into that when we come back after this.
Sounds good.
Chip and Gale continue to explore the park. Wow, I love the tower in Rapunzel's forest.
And I loved Rapunzel's Lantern Festival. The ride was so romantic.
Hi everyone, welcome back to part two of A Magical Time at Tokyo DisneySea Fantasy Springs.
Mm-hmm. So we've got Chip and Gale as we saw in part one, and now we're gonna go back with them as Chip and Gale continue to explore the park.
Yes.
Okay, so they are exploring this DisneySea park. So to explore means to look around a new area that you haven't been before to learn more about it or to find out what is there. So if they are exploring the DisneySea park, they are looking at every area of the park, seeing what they can do there, what fun things they have, what rides they can go on, and what food they can eat, probably.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot to explore at DisneySea. Mm-hmm.
So again, this time I will be Chip and you will be Gale.
Okay.
So Chip says, wow, I loved the tower in Rapunzel's forest.
Oh, Rapunzel is the Disney character with the super long hair, right?
Mm, that's right. Her hair grows and grows and it causes lots of trouble.
Indeed. And they were at the tower. A tower is a very tall building or structure. So for example, everyone's heard of the Eiffel Tower, right? Mm-hmm. The Eiffel Tower in Paris is a famous landmark.
Okay, yeah. So usually when we think of a tower, we think of something with a narrow base that's very tall, right? So just like, I think I remember, you know, Rapunzel is a character that was up in a tower and she would let down her hair from the tower.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is Rapunzel's forest. Mm-hmm. So a forest is an area with many trees growing together. And it's often seen in, you know, in lots of these kinds of stories, these fantasy stories like Rapunzel.
Yeah.
And other stories like this, you have forests where magical things happen. It's maybe a dark place to go into, in between the trees. Mm-hmm. And in this case, Rapunzel's Forest is the name of a ride or an area at DisneySea.
Yeah, and Gale continues, and I love Rapunzel's Lantern Festival. The ride was so romantic. Okay, Lantern Festival. We have that in Taiwan, don't we?
Taiwan does have a Lantern Festival. And it's always very bright and colorful. And it's nice to see.
Yes. So a lantern is a light in a box that you can carry. Mm. Or there are also the different types of lanterns that you put up into the sky, right?
That's right. And also, I don't think you can always carry them because especially with the Lantern Festival here in Taiwan. Some of them are very big.
Indeed.
And it's just, yeah, a light inside something can be called a lantern.
All right. And for example, we use a lantern to light our way in the dark forest.
Okay. Okay, so they said it's so romantic. So romantic means it's allowing or encouraging feelings of love. So the expression of feelings of love, people falling in love, it's the kind of scene that makes people want to, you know, share their love with others. Mm-hmm. It also is, you know, a category of like books and movies. Some people like to watch romantic movies, which are movies about people falling in love, or books that are romantic books are also about people falling in love.
Oh yeah, true. Just like there's also a category of movies, romantic comedies, right?
Okay.
And people often call them rom-com.
Rom-com, yeah. So a romantic comedy meaning a funny movie
about
people falling in love.
Exactly. So are you a romantic person?
I am not a very romantic person, but I can enjoy a rom-com from time to time.
Okay. All right. So we learned a little bit more about Chip and Gale and what they were doing. And let's find out more after the break.
Now, are you as excited about the next area as I am?
Yes. Peter Pan's Neverland. Here we come.
I can't wait to ride Peter Pan's Neverland Adventure.
As a kid, you wished to help save John from Captain Hook, right?
You'd better believe it. And I'm sure that you're looking forward to seeing Tinkerbell.
You got that right. Now let's go.
Welcome back. So where we left off, Chip and Gale were continuing to explore DisneySea. So Chip said that he loved the tower in Rapunzel's Forest, and Gale really liked Rapunzel's Lantern Festival because it was so romantic.
Yeah, I think girls usually like the romance, right? Okay.
All right, well, let's find out where they're going to go next.
Excited.
So Chip says, now, are you as excited about the next area as I am?
And Gil responds, yes, Peter Pan's Neverland. Here we come.
Okay. So they're both very excited about this next place, and it's Peter Pan's Neverland.
Yes, I love Peter Pan.
Yeah, Peter Pan is a great character. He can fly. He never grows up.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, so they're going to go to his Neverland, which in the books and in the Disney movies is this magical place.
Yes.
Where there's lots of magical things that happen, and I think sounds like a very exciting place to go.
Yeah, and I hear they never get old there.
That's right. You never grow up, so you can be a kid forever.
Ooh, fun.
Chip says, I can't wait to ride Peter Pan's Neverland Adventure.
That sounds like fun.
Yeah, so I wonder maybe they're going to fly like Peter Pan.
Mm-hmm. And Gale says, as a kid, you wished to help save John from Captain Hook, right? So Captain Hook is the character in Peter Pan that's the bad guy.
Yeah, he's the bad pirate character. He has a hook for a hand.
Yes.
And that's maybe why his name is Captain Hook.
Exactly. So captain is a noun and it means the boss of a ship or plane. So for example, the captain navigated the ship safely through the stormy seas.
Mm-hmm. So as you mentioned, it can be either on a ship, like a boat, or on an airplane. You might hear them say, like, this is your captain speaking.
Exactly.
And they'll tell you about the flight that you're on.
Yes.
Chip says, you'd better believe it. So he's saying, yes, of course you're right. You'd better believe it means you're exactly right. And I'm sure that you're looking forward to seeing Tinkerbell.
Oh, Tinkerbell. Everyone loves Tinkerbell, right?
So Tinkerbell is the little fairy.
With an attitude.
With an attitude, and she helps Peter Pan, right?
I think so, mostly, yeah. In the end. In the beginning, she was a little bit jealous and upset, but...
I think she loves Peter Pan, doesn't
yeah.
she?
Yeah, she does. So she got a bit jealous from the other girl. Continuing, Gail says, "You got that right. Now let's go." Okay, so she's actually super excited to see Tinkerbell and for all the rides, right?
Right, she's saying Chip got that exactly right. He knows what she wants, and it's to see Tinkerbell.
Yes.
All right, so they said look forward to seeing Tinkerbell. To look forward to means to eagerly anticipate or to really want to see something or do something in the future.
Mm-hmm.
So you can't wait to do it. You're really
excited
about doing something that will come later.
All right. So I look forward to seeing everyone next time in part 3 of this one.
Me too. So we'll see you then.
Bye.
Chip and Gail continue to explore the park. Wow, I loved the tower in Rapunzel's forest.
And I loved Rapunzel's Lantern Festival. The ride was so romantic.
Now, are you as excited about the next area as I am?
Yes, Peter Pan's Neverland. Here we come.
I can't wait to ride Peter Pan's Neverland Adventure.
As a kid, you wished to help save John from Captain Hook, right?
You'd better believe it. And I'm sure that you're looking forward to seeing Tinkerbell.
You got that right. Now let's go.
Hi, I'm Tina. 我们来看这一课的重点单字。第一个 tower, 名词塔，高楼。The tower in the town is really tall. 镇上那座塔真的很高。下一个单字 forest, 名词森林。Jesse got lost in the forest. Jesse 在森林里迷路了。下一个单字 lantern, 名词灯笼。The lanterns on the street lit up the night. 街道上的灯笼照亮了夜晚。Light up 指的是照亮。最后一个单字 captain, 名词船长。On a ship,is the captain who decides where to go. 在船上是船长指挥船的方向。接着我们来看重点文法。第一个 ,somebody is excited about 加名词某人对什么感到兴奋。Excited 是形容词意思是雀跃的。它所搭配的介系词是 about, 后面也可以接动名词。我们来看看这个例句。My brother is excited about getting his new car. 我弟弟对于买新车感到雀跃。下一个文法 ,here we come, 我们来了。这是一个地方副词的倒装用法。它的结构是 here 加上人称代名词加动词或者是 here 加动词加一般名词。我们先来看看 here 加人称代名词加动词的例句。This semester is over.Summer vacation, here I come. 这学期结束了，暑假我来了。我们再来看看 here 加动词加一般名词的例句。Hurry up, here comes the train. 快点，火车来了。最后一个文法 ,you'd better 加动词，你最好做某事。You'd 是 you had 的缩写。You 可以用其他人称代名词类推。注意，如果是否定用法，要把 not 放在 better 之后。我们来看看这个例句 ：You'd better not be late. 你最好别迟到。以上就是这一课的重点单字跟文法。我们下一课再见，拜拜。
Hey hey hey, it's Kiwi on the street.
I'm Kiki
and I'm Winnie.
Oh, Winnie.Did you know that I received a text from Dad today? And we were going to meet somewhere, and I was wondering where he was, and then he said, OTW.
OTW? Oh, Kiki, that means he's on the way.
Oh, I was wondering what he meant by that.
Wait, that means he's almost here.
He's almost here?
Let's go work on some abbreviations. Our first one is VS.
VS versus.
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 Versus. Very good. What about this second one? POV.
I have seen that, but I'm okay, not sure.
I will give you a clue. Okay. So you're watching a video from one type of angle.
Person of view?
Okay, oh, very close.
Oh, you got the
point of view.
Point.
So someone's point of view.
Okay.
Point of view.
Very
dun, 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 dun. Good. Very good. You got there. Okay.
Point of view.
Very okay. good. Point right. of view. Okay.
Point of view.
Oh, very good. Okay. And our last one is TBA.
To be announced.
Oh, very Whoa. Good. How about you're waiting for your exam results?
Some result to be.
So then, but then the teacher said, oh, I'm not done yet. It will be to be.
To be announced.
Very good.
Oh, you're, to be announced?
You're a professional. Whoa. You got it.
Oh, to be alarmed.
Oh, oh
alert.
Oh,
now, oh, Jesus.
It's to be announced.
Oh, announced.
I mean, yes.
You're so close.
To be announced.
Caught this one.
So what abbreviations did we learn today? Let's work on today's abbreviations. Our first one is VS, versus, versus. For example, who would win in a fight? Mario versus Luigi. Our second one is POV, point of view. Point of view. So for example, you would say, the story is told from the girl's point of view. And last but certainly not least, we have TBA. To be announced. To be announced. For example, you could say, the exam date is yet to be announced. That's all we have for today. Kiwi later.